simple toy cannon that's easy to make, and my boys have had loads of fun playing with it. I'll explain how to make it in a moment, but the thing I love about it is the fact that it allows children to explore energy, forces, and motion, all while making something. You can fire different things out of it. You can control how much you pull the rubber bands back. You can change the angle. In other words, you can explore projectile motion, the way in which things fly through the air. To make one of these cannons, you need to start by cutting off the bottom of one of these crisp tins. So we'll take the scissors, and we'll push them through, and you probably want to do this yourself because it's a little tricky. We'll cut it right the way around. Next, you want to cut two slits up close to the top, first on one side and then on the other. And what these are going to do is they're going to provide the attachment point for your rubber bands. So here go two rubber bands, one on one side and one on the other side, like this. Then, with some masking tape, you can secure the rubber band in place and strengthen the top of the can. So here we are, ready to go. And now we can tear that off. So the whole thing is ready and in place. So we can set that aside. And now we're going to take a bottle. And the bottle, again, we're going to use scissors to poke a little hole in the bottle like that, and the same thing on the opposite side. Again, you want to be a little careful with the scissors, but with that in place, we're now going to take a pencil and we're going to push that through the two holes. Force it through, and now our bottle is ready. So we can assemble the entire device by putting this plunger in and securing it with the two rubber bands. Our cannon is now made and ready to fire. Now, of course, you can use any projectile you want, and I've got a variety of balls here. But of course, if you're playing inside, I suggest you use these scrunched up balls of tinfoil. You can drop them in, and using these, you can actually minimize the amount of wreckage that you're going to cause in your house.
No!
Okay, let me try with this. Whoops, not too short. Oh, missed. Yay! The cannon is a simple device to transfer energy from one thing to another. When I pull the bottle back, energy for me is stored in the rubber bands. And when I release the bottle, that energy is transferred into the movement of the projectile. In other words, into kinetic energy.
Why don't we make a stack of stuff and you have to try to knock everything down?
Simply asking a few questions while you're doing this activity might help you and your kids get a little bit more out of it. So which do you think makes for the best catapult?
Maybe the one that goes furthest.
One that goes furthest?
Yeah.
Yeah?
And one that goes highest.
And one that goes highest.
No, actually, but highest is really hard to measure.
Okay, so what's the tennis ball doing?
Oh, it's heavy.
It's
and
heavy.
It's just dropping.
Okay. So what does that mean if it's really heavy? What happens if it's really heavy?
It doesn't go high.
It doesn't go high.
It just goes up like that. I like this activity because it's quite kind of fun and it's kind of cool when you have to kind of go back and then remake your catapult and kind of make it better and better. And see how it goes once you've done it.
I think they're easy to make, they fly really well, and I think we should get them into my school.
Oh wow, look at that. Look at those big red bubbles.
Looks beautiful, doesn't it, Mama?
It does look beautiful.